You want to know how to determine which bearings and what color they are if you don't have markings like this on your crankshaft, this on your crankcase, or this on your conrod? If yes, keep watching this video. A couple of people ask me, what if I don't have these numbers? What about if these numbers here on the crankshaft have been erased for some reason? The previous owner decided to race the bike and make the crankshaft lighter, took these numbers off. He thought, okay, that's fine, I don't need them, I recorded them, I have them on a piece of paper. He forgot to mark them again, and then he sold the bike to you, and you are called to solve this problem. And what if we don't have these numbers, which are pretty easy to wear out? And it happened to many people. So thank God Suzuki has given us a few charts on the original service manual that talks about exactly how can you identify the correct color. Let's start with the conrods. What you have to do is take out the bottom half of the conrod, remove the two bearings, which I had already. Now put them back together. These two pins, they have to be on the same side. So put back the conrod together without the bearings. Torque the conrod at the correct specifications to make an accurate job. And then you have to measure this diameter. And according to this diameter, we can tell what kind of conrods we have. A good way to measure these after you torque them to correct torque specifications is with telescopic forks. You tight it, and then you slide it across. You go to the micrometer and you take the measurement. Suzuki states that if we have from 39 millimeters to 39.008 millimeters, the code over here should be number one. If it's 39.008 to 39.016, then it's a number two, and we do have number two. So once you find that, I suggest you write here with a marker one or two. Now let's suppose we don't have these numbers, they've been erased for some reason. How can we know what kind of code is that? These codes here, they're always going to be from number one to number three, no more than that. This is how you measure all the conrod joins on the crankshaft. For number one, if it's number one, it should be 35.992 millimeters all the way up to 36 millimeters sharp. If it's a code for number two, you should find a 35.984 millimeters to 35.992 millimeters. And if it's number three, it should be 35.976 millimeters all the way to 35.984 millimeters. If you find less than code 1, you probably have a problem with your crankshaft and you might have to need to replace it. But make sure you do double check measurements, because not always measurements go the way they should go. So take your time and do a very accurate measurement, and if you're not sure, do a second and a third measurement. Make sure exactly what do you have there. And now let's go for the crankcases. We need to find what's the internal diameter in here. If we don't have any kind of indication of color or any kind of marks on a crankshaft or the crankcase, these are the ones. And here you can clearly see that it's all for all six joints, letter A. And it's always going to be letter A or B over there. No C, no D, nothing. If you have these markings wear off, this is the way to go. Now, this is going to be a time-consuming procedure, but a very necessary one, since you don't have any other way. You have to remove the bearings, first of all. You don't have to put anything else, even the gearbox, if it's out, that's fine. You have to put the upper crankcase right here on top of the lower crankcase, and you have to torque the crankcase, all the bolts in the correct specifications. And then somehow that's the difficult part. You have to go in there with a very long rod micrometer and measure the internal diameters without the bearings. If you find 39 millimeters to 39.008, that should be code A. However, if you find 39.008 millimeters all the way to 39.16 millimeters, that's gonna be a code B. Let's go back to the crankshaft and find out how can we identify the letters, which is always letters A, B, and C. And now let's go identify these codes right here. If you don't have these numbers, all you have to do is, again with a micrometer, and this is where you have to put the micrometer to measure the main joint or the crankshaft. Now Suzuki states that if we have 35.992 up to 36 millimeters, that's a code A. For code B, we should have 35.984 to 35.992 millimeters. And for code C, 35.976 to 35.984 millimeters. Alternal diameter on each one of the joints. So again, make sure you measure correctly. It's really easy to be deceived. It's really easy to go just a tad lower and just a tad higher. Make multiple measurements until you are absolutely correct what you have here. And this is how you can find all the codes in here that Suzuki has put on the crankshaft, crankcases and conrods if you don't have them. Another way to find, which is a bit easier, it's to measure the thickness of each bearing. Unfortunately, you can't do it with these micrometers. As you can see, these micrometers, they have both ends flat. You need a different micrometer for that purpose. The ones that they have to have this top end rounded, so you can adopt with a round surface of that. If you try to do it with this, look what's happening. This side we're okay on this end because there's no problem, but the flat surface cannot adopt with a curved surface of the bearing. So you need to have the top end being rounded. You need a different micrometer for that, like the one I show you here on this picture. However, remember, this is the conrod and goes up and down thousands and thousands of RPMs every minute, and it's been going there like that for several years. So there's a lot of pressure on that spot and that spot. There is pressure on these ends here where the two joints met, but not as much as here. So it only makes sense that this surface from here to here, it's gonna be a bit more worn, and you can see it actually, than these edges. So it only makes sense if you have a worn bearing that you need to find out the thickness of it. It only makes sense to measure on that end or that end where the pressure and the friction was less. You have far more chances if you measure here to have a more accurate measurement than if you do the measurement here. This is my thoughts, not the expert's thoughts. If you find the thickness between 1.480 to 1.484 millimeters, this is a green. A black should be from 1.484 to 1.488 millimeters. The brown, which is that one, it should be from 1.488 millimeters to 1.492 millimeters. And last but not least, the yellow color should be the thicker one, 1.492 to 1.496 millimeters. And this is how you identify the colors. Now let's go for the crankcases. And again, for the crankcases, if you find 1.486 millimeters to 1.490 millimeters, that should be a green. If you however find 1.490 to 1.494 millimeters, that is a black. Going higher up, 1.494 all the way to 1.498 millimeters, that should be a brown. And last but not least again, the thickest one, 1.498 to 1.502 millimeters, that is the yellow. And there you have it. Again, I'm suggesting do the hard way. I know it's far more time consuming. I know you have to put, especially for the crankcase joints, you have to put one crankcase on top of the other and torque it in the correct torque specifications and do measurements, and it's really hard to get in the end. You have to have your equipment, but it's much better than just measure the thickness of that. Now, before you put your engine together, it's a good idea to check your gearbox. Amongst teeth missing, broken, and everything else that looks on a first glance all right or not all right, there's one more thing that you should check, and this is the forks and the grooves of the gear shifting mechanism. So we have 1, 2, and 3. The first thing you should look, and you don't have to remove anything from your gearbox, is the gap between the fork and the groove. That should be done with your filler gauge. 0.10 to 0.30 millimeters for all three of them. So if I put 0.10 here, should fit all right, but if I try to put 0.30, it should fit just in. And in this case, it doesn't, which is good. 0.10 goes in, 0.30 no, and 0.10 goes in, but 0.30 it won't. But even if it fit just, that'll be okay. The service limit is 0.50, so half a millimeter. If you have half millimeter or more, then you have to replace either the fork or the groove, the gear, or both. Which one? You have to remove them and measure them individually. For forks 1 and 3, the thickness between one or the other end should be 4.8 to 4.9 millimeters, while for number 2 it should be 5 to 5.1 millimeters. If the thickness is less than that, then you have to replace the forks. For the grooves 1 and 3, again, we have 4.6 to 4.7 millimeters. If it's more than that, you have to replace. And for number 2, it's 4.8 to 4.9 millimeters. More than that, you have to replace. And that's all for this video. I hope that video was helpful. I'll see you in the next video, which I'll have engine measurements about pretty much everything inside the engine. Look after yourselves. See you in the next one.